In today's numbers that matter, 507.2 billion pesos. That's the total infrastructure spending of the Philippine government in the first half of the year. The budget department says that figure exceeded the target expenditure for the sector by 5%. It's also 7.8% higher than the spending in the same period last year. The government plans to spend about 1.29 trillion pesos on infrastructure this year. And it isn't just jeepney drivers seeking a fare hike because of rising pump prices. Taxi operators are also calling for an increase in their flag down rates. According to the Philippine National Taxi Operators Association's Leo San Juan, they've already filed a petition last year, but they were only granted 5 pesos. They now want to raise that amount to 20, bringing the flag down rate from 40 to 60 pesos.
Nag-file na po kami ng motion for reconsideration doon sa 5 piso para maging 20. Tumaas na rin po ang cost of living ng mga driver. Bukod sa yan.
Now, bad news for motorists as oil prices shoot up for a 7th straight week. Gasoline prices will see the biggest jump at 1 peso and 10 centavos per liter. Kerosene prices, meanwhile, will go up by 70 centavos per liter. Diesel prices will also see a 20 centavo hike per liter. Now, fuel prices have been on the rise since July 17. Industry players cited Saudi Arabia's oil production cut as the main reason for the increase in pump prices.
The Philippine Labor Department lending a helping hand to micro and small businesses as part of efforts to ensure occupational safety and health hazards. The agency is looking to train some 50,000 safety officers of such establishments for free this year alone. Dole admits the lack of safety officers is among the most common violations of micro and small businesses. It hopes the free training for safety officers would also address the need for first aiders in every workplace. The Philippine Central Bank signs the United Nations-backed Principles for Responsible Investment. It's the leading global network of public and private institutions that's committed to incorporating environmental, social, and governance considerations into their investment practices. The initiative allows the BSP to deepen its understanding of responsible investing and benchmark its practices with other PRI signatories. Becoming a PRI signatory complements the BSP's membership to the network of central banks and supervisors for greening the financial system. It's also part of the BSP's 11-point sustainable central banking strategy. The Philippine Senate's Finance Committee Chair allaying concerns over the country's growing debt. Senator Sonny Angara says government is ramping up measures to scale back the debt-to-GDP ratio to 50% by the end of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s term. The figure currently stands at 63%, which Marcos himself had said was worrying. The national government's total outstanding debt in June stood at 14.15 trillion pesos.
We should start scaling back on debt. And that's what, exactly what the government is doing. If you look at the how much we spend on interest from the budget, we're spending about 11% on financial costs. Whereas there was a time, maybe 2 decades ago, ang ginagastos natin is maybe 30% for interest alone. So now you see there's at least kahit may utang tayo, most of the budget will go towards productive spending. So far, we're on schedule with that plan in 2024 to borrow less. The debt-to-GDP ratio will also go down.
Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri wants to expedite the procurement of defense equipment in the face of China's incursions in the Philippine waters. He says the process can be both stringent and quick to help the Philippines better respond to China's aggression. He's also pushing for the passage of the Philippine Defense Industry Development Bill, which seeks to promote local production of defense equipment. As for the budget, Senator Sonny Angara assures the public lawmakers will prioritize funding for agencies dealing with China's aggressive behavior.
There's increasing tensions in certain parts of the country, so definitely you need to pay attention to these issues, no? So I think that deserves increased funding, definitely. No.
Okay.
Whatever the threats are, then you should respond accordingly. with the budget. No?
You have Senator Chis Escudero suggesting set aside 100 million, build a structure in Ayungin.
Well, I think it's a great idea. But yeah, execution is the problem because just the bringing of supplies already creates some kind of conflict. But we should maybe use exhaust all means, you know, diplomatic and otherwise, so that we can exert our sovereign rights over these areas.
Meanwhile, Angara says a sensitive approach is needed in revamping the military and uniformed personnel pension fund system. He admits it will be difficult for those already in service to make sudden individual contributions. He adds lawmakers need to further scrutinize proposals for the MUP pension reform.
Clearly, it's already very difficult to sustain because now the pensions are even bigger than the salaries. Nagbabalun siya. There are no contributions to source the pensions from. That's the difficulty here. So at some point, you really have to make it contributory. So yung madali nga dyan, as I said earlier, is you will ask the new entrants to contribute. But at what point do you ask those in the service already because they've given their blood, they've shed, some have given their lives actually, no? So it's very sensitive and we have to be very sensitive to, yung pagkukonsulta is very important here. And the military, I think, has told us that they don't want to feel like they're being singled out. So it should be a holistic reform of the pension system.
Manila's finance chief earlier allayed concerns over the mandatory contributions. Secretary Benjamin Diokno said government is proposing a loan restructuring for MUPs to help them with the required contribution. Diokno had warned the country may face a fiscal collapse if government fails to overhaul its MUP pension system. Motorists passing through the Manila-Cavite Expressway will have to pay higher toll beginning today, August 21. Jackie Manabat filed this report.
Cavitex started collecting higher toll today, August 21. That's on a holiday Monday. The Manila-Cavite Toll Expressway or Cavitex is not expecting much motorists today. However, today, August 21, is the first day that they will be collecting higher toll as approved by the Toll Regulatory Board or TRB. Cavitex traverses the coast of Manila connecting Ross Boulevard to Cavite with two toll plazas in Parañaque Toll Plaza and Kawi Toll Plaza. For Class 1 vehicles traveling from Laia exit to Longos, Bacoor, and vice versa will have to pay 35 pesos toll from previous 33 at the Parañaque Toll Plaza. Class 2 vehicles will be charged 70 pesos instead of 67, and Class 3 will be paying 104 pesos from 100. Meanwhile, motorists traveling from Longos, Bacoor, and Kawit will be charged at the Kawit Toll Plaza. Class 1 vehicles will have to pay 73 pesos from 64. Class 2 will be charged 146 from previous 129. And Class 3 will be paying 219 from 194. The TRB said that they did not expect that these changes will be imposed amid a series of oil price hikes. TRB said these were approved months before and based on the concession agreement between the Metro Pacific Tollways Corporation and the government, which allows for periodic adjustments every 3 years.
The local government of Quezon City launches a program that aims to employ more persons with disabilities after it found 14% of PWDs in the city are jobless. The Kasama Ka initiative aims to hire a total of 300 PWDs who will be assigned to different departments and offices based on their skills and capabilities. Those who will perform well will be given an opportunity to become a permanent employee. Apart from employment, PWDs are also given social welfare assistance, livelihood training, and urban farming starter kits. The city is also distributing assistive equipment, including hearing aids, eyeglasses, wheelchairs, among others.